गुड मॉर्निंग श्वेता. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द सेवेंथ चैप्टर विच इज नथिंग बट प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस. ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस थ्री डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस इन दिस चैप्टर. फर्स्ट वन इज द बाइनोमियल वन, द सेकेंड वन इज द पॉइसन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड द थर्ड वन इज द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके, नाउ दिस बाइनोमियल एंड पॉइसन, बाइनोमियल एंड द पॉइसन विल डील विद योर discrete distribution. Discrete means you will be having as a breaking one. It will be a step function. So binomial and Poisson distributions will be handling discrete probability functions, whereas our normal distribution will deal with the continuous function. Okay, so what are the two types of distribution we have? We have the discrete distribution and the continuous distribution. Now what is discrete distribution? That means these binomial and Poisson distributions are coming under discrete distribution. Now, what is binomial distribution? Binomial distribution is derived or was discovered by our James Burnley. Okay, we already learnt our binomial theorem, is it not? In our 11th standard, second unit, last exercise, we learnt about the binomial distribution. When does this binomial distribution come into picture? You do a random experiment, okay, and when the outcomes are only two, that is, you only have two outcomes, whatever the experiment be. The experiment here, they have taken example as tossing a coin. What will be the two outputs? Only head or a tail. Nothing else can come into this example. Similarly, for a die, what will be a die? Die is a cube, small cube used for playing. So that die, when you toss, you can get only that six heads, okay, but you cannot take that as all the six. You can say it is in the die whether the number is even or odd. Again, only two conditions we are discussing. So a random experiment whose outcomes are only two types, namely the success or the failure. Okay, now coming to the binomial distribution definition. So a random variable x is said to follow the binomial distribution, okay, when n parameters are involved. So what will be the distribution? It is ncx p power x q power n minus x, where p plus q should be always equal to 1. P plus q should always be equal to 1. Okay, now we are going to see the distributions can be handled only under the certain conditions. So what are the conditions? First one should be n should be finite, that is the number of trials should be finite. Then the trials should be independent of each other, that is they should not be dependent on the previous trial. Then the probability of success p is constant, and the every trial there are only two possible outcomes. Okay, at the end of each experiment or the trial, the outcome should be always two, either success or failure. Now we have to derive the mean and variance for the binomial distribution. Okay, you just go through this given in the book. Okay, we will take this as assignment. You can write this. That is the derivation of the mean and variance for the binomial distribution. Okay, when you work it out, you will understand how we are getting the mean. Mean for a binomial distribution will be NP. Okay, the variance would be NPQ. Variance is NPQ. So the mean is NP, variance is NPQ. What are the properties? Properties is if the binomial distribution is symmetrical, that is exactly half, that is p equal to q equal to 0.5, okay, then the binomial distribution, the variance is always less than the mean, that is npq is always less than the mean. Okay, so with this idea we are going to do the exercise. Okay, keep noting, because in the exercise we will be having our theoretical questions. So you have to be marking this from this picture pages. Okay, first question, first question in exercise 7.1 is the definition for the binomial distribution. So what is that? It is in page 45, the definition. What is the definition for the binomial distribution? Now, and the second question is, what is the binomial distribution or how the it is defined? What is a Bernoulli trial? So you can take these examples, with the examples you can give. So in this page 45, you can mark from here and you can mark it till here. Okay, now coming to what were the conditions for the binomial distribution is in page number 46, all these four conditions. Okay, then the derivation. So derivation for the mean and for the variance. Okay, then the properties. So all this part has to be written in your classwork notebook as the exercise 7.1. Now coming to the second question in 6th question in 7.1. Okay, what is that? They are saying 5% of the items produced to be defective. Okay, 5% are defective. So you take that as 0.5. That is 5 by 100, which is equal to 0.05. Okay, we will see here. The defective percentage is 5%. That means it is 5 by 100. I take that as P. Now what will be my Q? We know P plus Q will give me 1. So Q will be 0.95. Now they are saying the number of items is 10. You want exactly 3 defectives. So first you can form the binomial function distribution. That is, P of X is equal to, use the formula, NCX P of X into Q of N minus X. So what is that? It is P of X equal to 3 is equal to, instead of N I put 10, instead of C X I put 3. So this is 0.05 whole power 3 into 0.95 whole power 7. When I multiply using the calculator, I will get the answer as 0.0105. Okay, you have to use a calculator, and it should be a simple calculator. You cannot go for a scientific calculator. Okay, the next question, that is the next part of the question, says at least 2 defects. At least, so at least I want 2 defects, so it should be 2 or greater than 2. So this is how we take it out. So that can be found out by 1 minus P of X less than 2. Now 1 minus what is less than 2? You will have X is equal to 0 plus X is equal to 1. So I write the formulas NC0 P naught X Q power N minus 0 plus NC1 P power 1 Q power N minus 1. Or you can directly, so I can directly substitute N as 10, P as 0.05 and Q as 0.95. Substitute, then I find the answer and then I add it. Okay, coming to exactly 4 defects, I substitute 4 for X. Okay, so I get it as 0.0096. Okay, now we have to calculate the mean and the variance. The mean is NP, so 10 into P is 0.05, so I'll get 0.5. NPQ 10 into 0.05 into 0.95, so I'll be getting 0.475. okay, now moving on to the our next question, which is our 7th question. Okay, in the question, in our exercise, in a particular university, 40% of the students are having a newspaper reading. Okay, newspaper reading, 9 university students are selected. So my N will be 9, and find the probability that none of the selected have newspaper reading habit. All the selected have newspaper reading habit. At least 2/3 have newspaper reading habit. Okay, now how I'm going to take this? Now N equal to 9. Okay, now the question is 40% of the student. So let P be 40%. So my Q will become 1 minus 0.4, that is 0.6. Now what will be my general P of X? It is 9CX, 0.4 power X and 0.6 power N minus X. Now First question is, none have newspaper reading habit, so x is equal to 0. When I substitute, I get 0.01008. Now, coming to the second question, all have newspaper, so all, so x will become 9. So what will be that? 0.4 power 9. That also we can find out the answer. Now, at least 2/3. What is at least 2/3? 2/3 of the 9. So that will become 6. So when p is at least, so it should be greater than or equal to 6. So what are all the possibilities for that? P of x equal to 6 plus p of x equal to 7 plus p of x equal to 8 plus p of x equal to 9. Then I start substituting. I start substituting 9 c6 into 0.4 power 6 and 0.6 power 3. This is the first one. Then for the second one, 9 c7 0.4 power 7 and 0.6 power 2 plus 9 c8 into 0.4 power 8 and I substitute and I expand, I will find the answer. Okay, you have to slowly multiply. This is a big answer. You have to be very careful. Even a small decimal would make a difference. The value after the decimal will be making a difference. So you don't cut off. You don't round off. You can take till 6 digits. Okay, after the decimal you can very well take to 6 digits. Okay, now coming to the 8th question. Now they have given n equal to 3. Okay, we can take n equal to 3 from the question. When I read the question, you will understand. What is the question? In a family of 3 children. Okay, so the n will be 3. Girl or a boy. So, if a girl, it is 1 by 2. And for a boy, it will be 1 by 2. Now, what will be exactly 2 girls? So, let x represent the girls. So, x equal to 2. So, 3 is c2. 1 by 2 the whole squared and 1 by 2 power 3 minus 2. So it is 3 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 2 which is equal to 3 by 8 which is equal to 0.375. Now, 9th question. Defects in the yarn, okay, in a local mill is approximately up to or the mean is 1.2. Then, a length of 6 meters. So n is equal to 6. So, we have to find the probability for 2 defects. Now, they are given NP or the mean is 1.2, N is 6. So, 6 into P, you will get P, that is 0.2. Q, with this, you can find Q which is equal to 0.8. Now, my general binomial distribution will be 6CX, 0.2 power X and 0.8 power 6 minus X. Now, fewer than 2 defects. So, it will be less than 2. So, x is equal to 0 plus x is equal to 1. Then, I can go ahead expanding with the formulas and I can find the values 0.65536. Now, we have P as 18%. Why 18% of the bowls are defective? So, P is equal to 18%. So, it will be 18 by 100 which is equal to 0.18. And out of which 4 bowls are chosen. So, it will be 4. N will be 4. What is Q? Q is 0.82. With this, we are going to check for exactly 1 defect. Okay. Exactly 1. So, it will substitute X is equal to 1. Now, when there are no defectives, none. So, it will be X equal to 0. Then, at least 2 defects. So, at least means it is less than or equal to 2. Okay, the question is at most. So, at most, so it should be less than or equal to 2. If it had been at least, it should be greater than or equal to 2. You should be very careful in interpreting the word to the mathematical sign. Okay, so it is P of x equal to 2 plus P of x equal to 1 plus P of x equal to 0. Already 0 value you know and for 1 value we know. So, you can take these two values and you can directly add it. Okay. Only you have to find for P of x equal to 2. So, that the final answer is 0.97972. Now, coming to the 11th question. Okay. The probability of the success is 0.09. okay, whereas the failure is 0.91. okay, now you have to find n. okay, they have given the probability for at least one success is greater than 1/3. At least one success, at least one means x greater than or equal to 1 is greater than 1/3. That is 1 minus p of this will become s than 1 is greater than 1/3. Now if I say equal to 0, only less than 1 is equal to 0. So 1 minus p of x equal to 0 is greater than 1/3. Okay, how I am getting this? I am going to simplify. I am going to multiply this whole row into minus 1. So minus 1. Now I am going to multiply this with minus 1. So minus 1 plus p of x equal to 0 is greater than 1/3. Okay. Why? Minus 1 into minus 1. This is minus 1. Minus of minus plus. Now I am taking this minus to that side. This minus 1 will become plus 1. So, and I can change the sign. Okay. So, p of x is equal to 0 less than 2/3. Okay. Less than 2/3. When I multiply by minus itself, this greater than sign will become less than sign. Okay. So, finally, I'll be getting p of x is equal to 0 is less than 2/3. I substitute the value n c 0. 0.09 power 0 and 0.1 n is less than 2/3. Finally, I'll be having 0.91 power n is less than 2/3. For this, I'm going to use log. So n log 0.91 should be less than log 2/3. Okay. So what can I say? I'll find it in the logarithmic tables, and I can say, for n equal to 5 alone, this value is less than 2/3. Okay. Log 0.91. What value for 5 alone? It is less than 2/3. Now, we are going to the 12th question. What is the 12th question? Among 28 professors, okay, 18 drive foreign cars, 10 drive local cars. Okay, 18 by 28 will give you my P, whereas we are going to say 5 of the professor, so N will become 5. What is Q? Q will become 1 minus 9 by 14, which is equal to 5 by 14. Now with these two things, I have my general binomial distribution. Now they say at least 3 foreign cars, at least. So P of X should be greater than or equal to 3, which is equal to P of x equal to 3 plus P of x equal to 4 plus P of x equal to 5. I substitute in the formula. Okay. You have to be very careful. Finally, I will be getting 14 power 5 in the denominators. Totally, I will take the 14 power 5 denominator and I can add all the numerators, because I will make them as a like fraction. Finally, I will be getting as 0.7536. Okay. 0.7536. Now coming to the 13th question, where out of 750 families, 4 children, so I'll take n as 4. Again, the boy girl probability will be 1/2 1/2. I'll take the variable x for a boy. Okay, so the general form will be 4cx 1/2 power x into 1/2 power 4 minus x. Okay, why I go for the boy is most of the question there equal probabilities for boys and girls, so I'll take x for a boy. Okay, now for at least one boy, so it should be p greater than or 1, that is 1 minus p less than 1, or 1 minus p x is equal to 0. So it is 1 minus 4c0 1/2 power 0 1/2 power 4. So finally I'll be getting 15/16. Now I have to multiply this for 750 families, so I will be getting 703. Now at most two girls, now maximum I should have only 2 girls out of 4 children. Okay, or house la 4 per irukanga, 4 kutties, the 4 kutties la 2 girls kandipa irukano, adha at most, adukku mela pokudadu. Appuram inge 2 boys, idu or combination. Adutha combination, 1 girl 3 boys. Add the combination 0 girls and 4 boys. ஓகே அட் மோஸ்ட் டூ கேர்ள்ஸ். அப்போ இந்த காம்பினேஷனுக்கு நம்ம பாய்ஸ் தான் எடுத்துக்கிறோம். ஸோ வி ஆல் கோ வித் எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டூ, எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு த்ரீ, எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஃபோர். நீங்கள் கேட்கலாம், மேம் நம்ம கேர்ள்ஸை தான் மேம் எடுத்தோம், அப்புறம் எப்படி நம்ம பாய்ஸோட கம்பேர் பண்ணுறோம்னா, த வி டேக் இன் எக்ஸ் ஆஸ் ஃபார் பாய். ஸோ ஃபார் அ பாய் வாட் ஆர் த காம்பினேஷன், வென் த கேர்ள்ஸ் காம்பினேஷன் இஸ் லைக் திஸ், த பாய்ஸ் வில் பி லைக் திஸ். ஸோ எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டூ, எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு த்ரீ, எக்ஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஃபோர். அக்கார்டிங்லி ஐ சப்ஸ்டிடியூட், ஐ டேக் த திங்ஸ் இன் காமன், 1/16, அண்ட் ஐ ஆட், ஐ பி கெட்டிங் 11/16. நவ் ஐ ஹாவ் டு மல்டிப்ளை தட் ஃபார் 750 families, I'll be getting it as 516. Now, for the third portion, children of both the sexes, what are the combinations? Either 3 girls, 1 girl, 3 boys, 1 girl, 2 boys, 2 girls, or 1 boy and all 3 girls. Okay, it can be only in these 3 combinations. We substitute this and I can say we can have 656 families in that manner. Okay. Now we are going to the 14th sum, which is saying n equal to 15. Okay, 15 business travelers we are going to check for carrying a laptop. After that, 40% carry the laptop. So 0.4, and what will be Q? It will be 0.6. So what is the general form? 15 CX, 0.4 power X and 0.6 power 15 minus X. So 3 travelers they are asking, you can directly substitute in the formula. Then 12 travelers will not have a laptop, that is 15 minus 12, or it is 3. So 3 will have a laptop. So we can say P of X equal to 3. Just now we have found out the answer, we can use the same answer. At least 3 travelers have a laptop. So 1 minus P of X less than 3. Then I start expanding the formula. Then I substitute the values and I will be finding it. This is a big bit sum, Shweta. You have to be very careful in substituting and finding the values. Okay? I will send the photos of all these sums which I have done, because I know the video quality is shaking. I know you will not be able to view what I have sent. So, kindly bear with me for this time. Next time I will send all the in the WhatsApp, I'll send all the photos of the sums. Okay, copy this all in your classwork notebook. Okay, thank you.